forgive me if I do any mistake, because English is my second language. Can you guess what is my first language? Python. When I was a kid, almost 5 years old, people used to ask me, what do you want to be? And you know what I say? I always say, I want to be a scientist. I want to do some research. That time I don't know what is research. But my answer was always the same. And here I am, doing a research. Good evening everyone, I'm Devki. I'm doing a PhD on cloud. You're thinking, what is cloud? Nana, don't misunderstand about the cool, really fancy cloud. My cloud is not like that. I work in a lab with bunch of other nerds, do exhaustive programming. Then you think, what is my cloud? You know, the same question I asked myself when I started my PhD. The first thing I do is, I went on Wikipedia. And Wikipedia says that cloud is a model for enabling ubiquitous, convenient, on-demand, blah, blah, blah. Everything goes away from my head. I don't understand anything. Then what I did, I thought it's better to go and read some other article. First article I found. And they state that cloud is a bag, storage bag, where you can store all your digital stuff, like pictures, emails. Then I thought, if it's a storage bag, where is it storing? It is not storing in the air, protected by God. It must be somewhere. Then I go to another document. Next document say that you are sending all your data to someone else's computer. My phone sends pretty much everything to the cloud. I don't want my dirty picture to be seen by anyone else. Then I read more. And finally I figured out that the other's computer are big data centers, coordinated by some larger companies like Google, Amazon, Microsoft. And can you guess where the data centers are? They are scattered everywhere. Can you believe? Microsoft have a data center in Pacific Ocean. And Google have a data center at the glaciers of Iceland. What about Sahara Desert? Do they have any? No. Sahara Desert doesn't have any. It's very hot. And cloud wants something cool. And also, because of hot, cloud may melt. And no one want their stuff got wet. Coming back to my PhD. It doesn't go that well as I predicted initially. See, I'm 30, still single, staying so far from my family. However, I'm growing. I'm growing as a person. I'm growing my knowledge. I'm growing my tummy. I'm growing my white hairs. Please don't let me talk about hair fall. By the way, only once a year I go home. And only for a short period of time, so I don't have much time to meet my friends. During my last visit to India, I met one of my friends after 3 years. During college time, he used to say, I am like Casanova, I don't want to get engaged. And he was holding an 18-month-old baby. What is this? I was really surprised and devastated together. The main problem start when he start asking me, so when are you getting married? Where is your girlfriend? Oh God, it doesn't mean I'm living in UK that I have a girlfriend. It really hurts my feeling. You know what I do to overcome that? I treat my PhD as girlfriend. There are a lot of resemblance. You know, both the relation starts with the proposal. Both are very demanding and you have to work hard, really hard, to satisfy them. If your girlfriend wants to stay you overnight to help her, you can't say no. Similarly for PhD, if you have a paper deadline, you can't stop. You have to work overnight. I don't remember how many sleepless nights I spent in my PhD. By the way, for PhD, you have to publish some paper. Publishing paper, those papers are reviewed by some reviewers and editors. And you know, reviewers are like whom? They are like Indian parents. Not your parents, your girlfriend's parent. And it's very hard to convince them. You have most probable chance of getting rejected. I will read one of the review to you. I got this. This is my review. It states that, "Dear Dr. Devki," they don't care if I have a PhD, but it's better to hurt my ego if I don't have. "Thanks for submitting your manuscript title something. We regret to inform you." I don't think they regret anything. "Your manuscript will not be included for publication in our journal." They want to say our awesome and the best available journal. "After careful consideration and extensive discussion among the editorial board," actually it was only him, "we feel this paper would be more appropriate for publication in another journal." They want to say some lesser impact journal that no one cares about. "Although the reviews are not entirely negative," actually it was pretty bad though, "it is evident that the manuscript does not meet our criteria of novelty and impact." They want to say my topic is not trendy. "Although you could address these issues in a revised manuscript that I have to do after collecting my scattered soul, we must decline further review. Intentions are clear. They don't want to read my paper again. So that you may submit it elsewhere without delay." They want to say, see how desperate we are. "Our decision in no way reflects any criticism or doubt about your paper in this work or your work in general, or maybe. Due to high volume of submission we receive," just exaggerating on my face, "and constraints of space," not really, paper is cheap and website doesn't have a size limit. "We hope you will consider to continue, continue to consider our journal for future manuscript." Means they are not desperate enough now, but in future they may be. "Sincerely, journal's editor," actually it's not editor, it's editor's assistant who might had a bad day, maybe fought with his or her spouse and released all her or his or her stress on my paper by rejecting it. Anyway, even after this much of scrutiny, if your paper got accepted, it means you are lucky. "I have published few of the paper. I can say now, I'm not the scientist that I imagined when I was 5 years old, but I'm pretty good. With my head in cloud, without getting wet. Thank you so much."